Now tonight, we're gonna look into Project Mockingbird. I'm gonna find out what all the hubbub is about. Bub. Well before Joshua Bardwell put out his video about Project Mockingbird, I had already been looking into it and was just a lazy old fart and didn't do anything about it. But tonight, that's all gonna change. If you have not seen Joshua Bardwell's video about Project Mockingbird or have been living under a rock and don't know what Project Mockingbird is, or you just don't go searching around in places maybe you probably should. I don't mean porn. Stop it right now. I don't mean Project Mockingbird. Let's take a look at our subjects tonight. Beta F4 flight controller on a 65 millimeter tiny whoop. The classic old Micro-Voo. I forgot the company that even made this, but I know it's somebody Micro-Voo, so they made a Micro-Voo. And, which you'll probably find surprising, the Shenderon Squirt. That's right, I've got Project Mockingbird set on this too. Why? I don't know, because it felt right. In brief, because I will link to Joshua Bardwell's video, and I will show you how I set it up as opposed to him, but that's when I get back home. For now, we're just gonna enjoy some flying. However, Project Mockingbird is a set of settings meant to make your brushed or brushless drone fly like an Inductrix. Why? Having never flown an Inductrix that I'm aware of, I have no idea why they fly so good and everybody wants to mimic them. But now you can just jump off the cliff with the rest of us lemmings anyway, because what the hell, right? In theory, Project Mockingbird, there goes a jet with Project Mockingbird on it. In theory, Project Mockingbird sets all your settings on here so this thing flies like a little demon. Let me tell you, I've already tried it out, and guess what? It works! Before anyone gets here, let's put a couple batteries on these things and see how they do.
On the left side, you can see the Beta F4 board without Mockingbird, and on the right side, you can see it with Mockingbird. Now, what Mockingbird attempts to do is to give you the ability to fly an acro air mode type settings in stabilized mode or angle mode, versus you can see on the left-hand side, I have the aircraft in air mode.
Right, we got the course set up. It's not lit yet. So we're gonna see how Project Mockingbird does on a course with me flying. And let's see who's here today. There's Code Red over there. Dave.
What's up?
Luis, how you doing? What's your name?
Zach.
Zach, how you doing?
Nice to meet you.
What's your name?
Thor.
Thor?
Yeah.
Okay.
Andrew's here. Luke else is here. Dante's here from the brain.
How's it going?
Thing, man. He actually flies.
Oh yeah.
You should have been over when I asked that question. All those people like, well, fly what?
Yeah, not many pilots.
And Matt's here, new guy. Oh, I never met him before, so he's new to me. It's a quick look at the course. You can see very Christmassy. It seems like it's lopsided with lights. Because I built it. But who cares? It's work. Let's go fly!
So we're waiting for Dante to fly. Come on, Dante. And is that connected to your brain?
Not this one.
No? Are you sure?
I can tell you my secrets.
What channel are you on?
R8.
R8? Okay, you're good to go.
Yeah, R8. All right, let's watch Dante actually fly a drone.
Are you nervous?
Too much pressure.
I know.
Keep your eye on this one. I may run around and chase him and see how he does and make him even more nervous.
Because that's me.
Oh, look at Dante go! I can't even keep up with him! No, you gotta go through hoops, Dante.
Where are you at?
I'm right here, I'm watching you, go ahead. There I am. Go ahead, go through hoops. I gotta tell the brain guy how to fly. Go ahead, think your way through that, Dante! Here he goes, he's gonna go through the tunnel now. He made it! Son of a gun! Who needs a brain to fly? No one!
Let's take a little bit of a look at the Project Mockingbird stuff, and then wouldn't you know it, Dante from the University of South Florida had another whoop there with Silverware on it, which is a brand new firmware that you can't really get yet. Although there is a board available, I'll leave the link down below, that Dante gave me for a board that runs Silverware. And let me tell you, that's, I thought Project Mockingbird was good. Project Silverware, or Silverware NFE, I think it's called. Links will be down below. That just blew it out of the water. I mean, they put it in racing mode and it was like it was on rails, man. It just always held its position. So wouldn't you know, the minute you make something up about or do a review on something like Project Mockingbird, somebody else comes along and goes, hey, did you see this yet? No. Maybe you just want to follow along with Silverware, but until then, Project Mockingbird will probably make you feel pretty good about yourself too. So give that a shot and let me know how you do. And if I get more updates on Silverware NFE, I will make a video about it and see if I can't get it on, like in beta. You can't do it with Betaflight. I don't think they have some weird way you have to hook up your flight controller to it, like little prongs or something. I'm like, oh, I'm not doing that yet.
On the left side is the Project Mockingbird Beta F4 board, and on the right side is the Silverware NFE board. And it is available with Silverware, but I'm not quite sure you'll get these same settings, but you can see in race mode, it barely dips, as opposed to the Mockingbird settings, which still dip a little bit and make it a little bit harder to fly it, but it's better than not having Mockingbird.
So to finish up the Project Mockingbird settings for your tiny whoop or small brushed aircraft, or even a brushless one, because there is a setting for the tiny hawk, I'll put a couple screenshots up of some of the settings that are there. I'll give you the links down below. You can go check it out at the Project Mockingbird site. They're always updating that. And I'll tell you the truth, I liked it. I liked it a lot. This is Betaflight specific. So if you have anything like 3.5 and up, this will work for you. If you don't, upgrade and then put them in. The settings aren't so insanely crazy that you can't figure it out or follow step by step like I did. Bardwell's video does a decent job of explaining it, although there's one or two differences that you'll probably see concerning the, what was that, the iTerms rotation or something like that. He had RPY and then the Project Mockingbird had RP. So who knows? I have RP. I follow the instructions.
So that's gonna do it for Project Mockingbird. I really, 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 really recommend that you do this. Set up your drone that way. Plenty of links down below. I'll put links to the boards you can buy them. Go get yourself some Project Mockingbird, Mighty Thor from the beautiful city of Tampa, Florida, flying some Project Mockingbird and making you jealous. See ya!